Now, this is a conspiracy that blows the mind of sane people. And I suspect that all of us in here are sane. It's unthinkable that somebody would plan to kill an entire people. See, you couldn't think like that. But don't you think that others don't think like that? Now I'm going to take you right back to the Bible for a minute. Do you believe that there is a God? You do? Yeah, I mean, this magnificent thing called creation didn't just pop up. There's a creator behind it. Well, if there's a God, is there a devil? And if in the book of Psalms it says, ye are all God's children of the Most High God, well, are there a group of devils that are the children of the Most High Satan? See, if when the seventh angel sounds his trumpet, the mystery of God will be finished, according to the book of Revelations, then the revelation of one is the revelation of the other. Because if the mystery of God is finished, then the mystery of Satan and his devils is also finished. So today, in our little time, I want to introduce you to God and also introduce you to Satan that has planned our destruction and how we're going to beat the plan. Now, let's move on. Now, there is an article that is written concerning the aim of the government of the United States. And I just want to read something to you that, you know, the wiser ones among you can look it up because it's real. I ain't making nothing up. But let me just say this. See, unless somebody knows the truth and is not afraid to speak the truth, we're all destroyed. But to know this that I'm about to break down to you, to know it, and then be fearful to speak it, is to be complicit in the destruction of our people. So that's why I'm getting your blood off of my hands. But then, once you know, you are responsible. Now watch this. In a national security memo dated April 24th, 1974, titled Implications of Worldwide Population Growth for United States Security and Overseas Interests, the Secretary of State under George Herbert Walker Bush, named Kissinger, wrote, now I'm quoting Kissinger, he said, depopulation should be the highest priority of foreign policy towards the third world. Depopulation. Now, I want to get some dictionary words here. See, to depopulate something means to ravage, to ruin, to reduce the population of, especially by violence, disease, etc. Now I want you to watch how this goes. I don't want nobody sleep. I want to wake up soldiers to come. Get everybody awake, man, because this is your life. Now watch. Kissinger said, the United States economy will require large and increasing amounts of minerals from abroad, especially from less developed countries. Now they're gonna destroy the population mainly with third world countries. Now watch where they're headed. The policy paper entitled Rebuilding America's Defense is the white paper of the neoconservatives in their project for a new American century. And here's what this one says on page 60. The art of warfare will be vastly different than it is today. Combat likely will take place in new dimensions. Advanced forms of biological warfare that can target specific genotypes may transform biological warfare from the realm of terror to a politically useful tool. Now I'm gonna break some of these words down because our young brothers didn't bring their dictionaries with them and the old ones didn't either. And I had to consult my dictionary too. I looked at this. A genotype is a race or a kind. It's the fundamental constitution of an organism in terms of its hereditary factors. Now this means that these wise scientists of death are making pathogens. A pathogen is something that can cause a disease. They're creating this as a means of depopulating our planet of undesirables. Watch this now. They call it culling, C-U-L-L-I-N-G, culling the population. And if you look up the word cull, it means to pick out, to select, in order to discard or destroy. To discard or destroy unwarranted parts, something rejected as not being up to standard. So if you're poor and you're ignorant and you're black or brown, you are being selected for destruction. Now I'm gonna prove this. I just want you to hold on for the proof.